What if your speed training was actually preventing you from running faster and reaching your true max speed? While it might seem surprising, turns out that all-out sprinting over and over again might not make you any faster.
If you have your athlete run 30 meters all the time, or 40 meters, or 50 meters, sprinting all-out all the time, it's been proven that that will not help him develop their speed. That will help him remember their speed. You're basically making them record their speed and repeat the same speed every single time.
To continually progress and improve your speed, you need to challenge your body to work harder and push beyond its current limits. This idea is commonly referred to as progressive overload. You put in the work, you get the results. Seems pretty obvious. But what happens when, despite all that hard work, you're just not getting any faster? You may have just hit the speed barrier. Sounds like it's out of science fiction, but it's actually straight out of sports science. The term was first coined by the famed Russian sports scientist Nikolay Ozolin. The premise is that an athlete's speed should continually increase with their training age, but most of the time this doesn't happen. And the reason why is incorrect training. When you just sprint hard over and over again, you develop what Ozolin called dynamic movement stereotypes, which means you've trained your mind and nervous system to lock in your current speed. And no matter how hard you try, you are simply unable to move your limbs any faster. This is especially true when it comes to max velocity sprinting. So how do you break your speed barrier or prevent it from happening in the first place? New exercises and intensities that force the body and mind to adapt and become faster. Training like hill sprints, resisted sprints, sprinting specific plyometrics, they're all great. But when it comes to max velocity, one of the best ways to improve your top speed is with floating sprints or ins and outs, also known as fly, float, fly. While there are many variations, this is fundamentally how they work. Start with a hard 30 meter acceleration. This should be at or very close to all out. This is your first fly zone. Next, you float for 15 to 20 meters. The force production drops to 90 to 95%, but technique and turnover are maintained. The goal here is relaxed sprinting with great technique. The final phase is an all-out sprint for 15 to 20 meters. Make sure to check out the end of this video so you can watch Coach Kareem and Jeremy Dotson show you exactly how this drill is done. There are three substantial benefits that floating sprints provide. First, they help you hit a higher top speed. Most athletes will be able to go beyond their current top speed during the second sprint or fly zone. This is due to the potentiating nature of the float zone. The second benefit is better coordination between the flexors and extensors. The flexors are the muscles that raise your leg, the extensors push it down to the ground. Developing precise timing and coordination between these muscle groups has been proven to increase speed. And finally, they help develop relaxed sprinting. The float phase is fantastic at developing the ability to run fast with great technique while staying relaxed. This is an essential skill for finishing races strong without chopping your steps. I think this clip of Flojo is probably the best example of relaxed sprinting that I've ever seen. So floating sprints are a very powerful training tool that taxes the body and the nervous system. They're an advanced drill that shouldn't be introduced too early in the season or before an athlete's ready. But when used properly, they can deliver serious results. Now, let's see them in action.
A lot of research shows that by doing in and out sprints, the coordination between the flexors, the muscles that get your knee up, and the extensors, the muscles that put your leg down, increases, and thus the limb movement increases and your velocity will increase. It's a great exercise if learned how to do it the right way. What we're gonna do, we have three zones here. The first zone, Jeremy will start from a three-point start, pushing and accelerating as if he's coming out of the blocks. Once he gets to the first cone, he's gonna, it's an out, like it's a float. He's gonna try to maintain turnover and reducing the power output. That's his float zone or the out zone. Then he's gonna go in again, which is the sprint zone, in the last 15 meters by actually applying more force to the ground and hammering harder with his arms. So drive, sprint, float, sprint, or in, out, in. This is what we're doing, great exercise. We do it probably the second half of the specific preparation once the technical model is established to truly develop speed. So let's start from a three-point start and we're gonna go on you. It's driving, slow, sprint again. Very good.